It's that time of the year, FIFA 22 is finally here. I'm joined by my good guy, Alex, aka the FIFA Analyst, and we're gonna be showing you the top 10 things you need to know about this year's game.
On FIFA 22, ball control has changed a little bit with the contextual agile dribbling being turned off by default. This now means that you need to use the R1 button to control the ball, have it nice and close. If you're going to get a tackle come in, make sure you use that R1 button to evade that challenge. You can also use the L1 button to strafe dribble. This is where you can come backwards a little bit with the ball, make sure you don't get tackled by the opponent. It's a really effective way to use on FIFA 22.
And where's the best place to use it, would you say?
Inside the box, in the middle of the pitch, whenever the opponent's about to come and tackle you, if you haven't got a passing option on and you need to find your way out with that dribbling, that'll be the best place. Yeah, skills is something that everyone on FIFA wants to learn and master. We can give you three simple ones that you can go ahead and use. The first one is a ball roll. This is where you use the right stick. You push it in a 90 degree angle to the way that you're running for about half a second, and you can just shift the ball from one foot to the other. This stops you from getting tackled when an opponent comes in. The more advanced one is then to do a drag back. You use the L1 and the R1 button combined with the left stick. Push the left stick back, and in the way that you want to exit, you again will evade that challenge. Really useful inside the box, actually, if you want to go ahead and get that shot off. The more advanced one would be the ball roll scoop. This is where you have to use a 5-star skiller. You're going to do a ball roll, the first one that we mentioned, and you're then going to do a scoop turn, which is where you do square and X, push the left stick in the way that you want to exit. Have to be really quick on the six to do this, but that'll get you a lot of space. Take a shot, get the goal.
Which Premier League player would you choose that's a 5-star skiller?
One of my most fun ones, which a lot of people will be picking up at the start of the game due to his 79 rating, is Saint-Maximin. He's got those 5-star skills, he's got the techers, definitely one that you want to use. It's a very difficult thing to do on FIFA 22 when your opponent is pressing. Obviously, they're going to be in that final third and you need to try and get it out to your fullbacks. That's kind of one of the best ways to evade that press. What you can do is use a square button to switch it from your left centre back out to that right back if you needed to. But don't be afraid to go over the top. If you've got no options, play for territory on the pitch, go for an L1 triangle over the top of the pitch, aim for your winger and just play for that throw in if you need to.
Are there any certain formations that beat the press best?
You want to make sure that you've got width and men in the middle. So running a narrow formation, you will struggle to deal with the press. So make sure you've got some fullbacks, some wingers, a couple of men in the middle of the park, and that'll be fine for you. Free kicks and penalties can be difficult, but once you master them, you will get a lot of success from them. You're going to see whenever you're taking a free kick or a penalty, the circle, which is where you're then going to push the left stick, whether you want it in the top corner or the bottom corner. For free kicks, about 20 to 25 yards out, put the circle in the top corner, where the goalpost, where the crossbar and the post meet each other, about 2 bars of power, green time it. We'll talk about that in just a second, and that can be your best chance for free kicks. For penalties, you're better off probably going low, again, trying to put it in the corner. 2 bars of power, 3 bars of power, but do take note, the more power that you put on that penalty, the less chance you've got of putting that ball in the back of the net.
And in terms of end range, when it comes to sort of 30-yard free kicks, are we saying still 2 bars of power, or is it more?
You're going to increase the power there. You want to make sure that you've got someone that's got a lot of power, good free kick accuracy if you're going to take a shot from 30 yards out. Myself though, I prefer to just try and whip that in or maybe go short and then play from there. There's plenty of different passes to use on FIFA 22. You've got your simple ground pass with X, which is just when you're going to play it to someone's feet. You've got triangle, you've got a man running behind and you want to play that ball onto him for him to run onto. You're going to use a triangle, which is a through ball for that. You've then got the square, which we mentioned earlier on, to be able to switch the ball, which is where you put it just over head height, and that works really, really well. The most popular one at the minute is the over-the-top through ball, L1 triangle. If you've got that player running in behind and you want to find him, make sure you use the L1 triangle. Depending on how far away they are, you're probably going to look for about 2 to 3 bars of power. Obviously, if you're looking for a big switch, maybe like Alexander Arnold would do, then you're probably going to go for more, you know, 3.5, 4 bars of power there. Again, another popular one at the minute is the R1X driven pass. Let's say you've got your striker just on the edge of the 18-yard box. You want to find him, but there's a centre mid that may intercept that pass. Use the R1X. It keeps it along the ground. It's driven. It's hard. Your striker will take a good touch, and then you can get that shot off.
And if we're using flary players, the 5-star skillers and all that, what would be the button to used to do a flare pass?
Everyone loves a cheeky little back heel or a little Rabona or something. You can use the L2 button when you're doing a ground pass, when you're doing a cross, whatever you want to do. And what that will do is it will choose a specific animation to make it look more fancy.
Team of the Week is back. Every week, Alex will be taking you through the Premier League players and how to get the best out of them.
Gabriel Jesus has been given an 86 rated Team of the Week item. This is in the right wing position. Gabriel Jesus would have a recommended chemistry style of a Deadeye. This is going to go ahead and increase his shooting along with his short passing. So if he's out on that wing or of that striker position, you're going to get the absolute most out of him. He does have 4-star skill moves, 3-star weak foot, so do your best to get it onto that right foot to give yourself the best possible chance of putting the ball in the back of the net. Emile Smith Rowe 81 rated Team of the Week item is one that you may want to be going ahead and pick up on the cheaper end of the budget. In that left mid position with high attacking work rates and high defensive work rates, you're going to see him up and down that flank. You're going to want to ensure that you put a Hunter chemistry style on him. This will make sure that he's got the pace and the ability to shoot if he does get in behind for those goals. Kourtney Hause 81 rated Team of the Week item does include 67 pace, 81 defending and 85 physical. He is 6'3", so you can use that strength and physical to your advantage as he will tower over the majority of opponents that you will face. The chemistry style we would recommend here is Shadow to increase that pace and give him the best possible chance of keeping up with the attackers. And do bear in mind, you want to partner him with someone who has got a little bit more pace to make up in that department should you get caught from an over-the-top through ball in behind. Remember, if you have any questions related to the Team of the Week, please pop them down below in the comment section at myself, which is at the FIFA Analyst, and I'll go ahead and drop you a reply to give you some more recommendations. This year, FIFA 22, it's changed so that jockeying is now manual. You have no assistance from the computer. So when you are jockeying yourself, which is where you use the L2 button, you're going to make sure that you're very delicate on the left stick to stay tight to that opponent. Be careful of any skill moves that they may do. Another defensive tactic which you can use is the R1 button for second man press. What this will do is tell the closest AI defender to go and press the ball holder. You're going to see a green icon above that player's head, which will last for 4 seconds. Once that's gone, it will change to a red icon. That means that that player can no longer press that ball holder. And a bonus little tip, if you want to maintain a high line, press down and down on the D-pad again for an offside trap so your defensive line can step up and obviously catch people offside. But obviously, if you don't put the ball in the back of the net, you're not going to win the game. So shooting is a pretty big part. You can use something called time finishing, which is massive this year. The window for time finishing has been moved to 1 to 6, which means that it's easier for you to do. What actually is it? It's where you press the shoot button, circle. As your player pulls his leg back and is about to strike the ball, if you press shoot again, you're going to get that green time finish. If you're too early, you'll see a red icon above your head to say that you did it wrong and the shot will then be scuffed. And if you get a white icon, that means that you've done it too late and it had no impact on it. You can use this with heading, finesse shots outside the box are the strongest one right now. You can use it with power shots. When you are inside the box, you can just use a normal finesse shot, which is R1 circle, and that's going to give you the best chance to put the ball past the goalkeeper. And then obviously when it comes to heading, just make sure that you time that header correct. You whip the ball in, you have to make sure that just before the ball is about to reach your head, you then press that shoot button to time that right.
And in terms of low driven shots, what are the best ways to do that?
Low driven shots is where you use L1, R1, and then press circle. A little bit complicated to do, and what this will do is it will keep the ball along the ground, it will stop the defenders from blocking the ball, and obviously makes it hard for the goalkeeper to reach. However, at times they can be a little bit tricky to pull off, you have to make sure that you're doing it at the right sort of angle. Formations is something that comes down to personal preference, how you like to play the game in your particular play style. A word that you will hear a lot is meta. This is the most effective tactics available. So something like a 4-4-2, a 4-2-3-1, a 4-1-2-1-2 narrow tend to be the most meta tactics or formations that you can use. So if you like them, then go with them. However, if you prefer a 4-3-3 or maybe a 3-4-1-2, you can adapt it and go to what suits your style. When it comes to tactics, there's multiple different ways that you can have them set up. First of all, you go through your defensive style. Do you want your team to press? So you may run press on heavy touch or press on possession loss. Do you want to be rigid and have that shape? Make sure that you're structured. You can go with balanced. Do you like to sit deep and hit on the counter? Look for that drop back if that's something that suits you. When it comes to your attack, you can go and make it as how you want. Do you want them to be width? You might set that to 75, have a lot of width out on the wing. Do you want your players in box? Do you want more runners coming from deep? Push that up to 8, 9 if you wanted to. And then the beauty of it, something to new that got introduced this year. You can say whether you want to have a slow build-up, a fast build-up, direct passing when you've got the ball inside your own half. As soon as you get into that final third, there's a tactic where you can change it. So again, you can say, right, I want my players to show short, all go long, direct passing, get in behind, and that's a really good feature that we've added this year. Player switching is probably one of the things that separates the best from the rest. So originally you will use the L1 button to go between your players, your midfielders, your attackers and your defenders. When you press the L1 button, it will only ever change you to a person that's closest to the ball. This obviously is bad if you wanted to track an over the top through ball, a ball down the line when the ball's on the center circle. So you can pick up a skill called right stick switching. This is where you're gonna use a right stick. You're gonna flick it in the direction of the player that you want to change to. Say if you're controlling someone in the middle of the park on that center circle and you want it to change to your right back and he was just above you, you'd flick that right stick up and it will change directly to him. Again, FIFA have gone in and added in a new feature this year where you can actually press the right analog stick in and you're going to see some icons come above those players' heads and it will tell you to flick it left, down or right, whichever player it is, to change directly to them. So that can be a really effective way to go ahead and learn right stick switching for a beginner. High promotion is a brand new feature that got brought in this year and it's taken FIFA to a whole new another level. What it has done is given us 4,000 brand new animations on FIFA. You're gonna notice this at times where you can chest the ball down, put it onto your knee, you can have more physical stats inside the box. Lukaku, for example, will benefit from having this in. And the way the system has been brought in, which I think you know a little bit about, which we'll talk about in a second, is where they've actually taken data live from a proper football match and proper game scenarios. It's taken directly from the game, which is giving you that more realistic, authentic feel on the game. How was it for you when you went there?
So yeah, I was fortunate enough to be there with the players and they had these motion capture suits on. And what that enabled them to do is then go through their training session and it would capture all the right data based upon their movements. That's then taken into the game, so players would then have more realistic movement on pitch in there. And then of course, as a fan, you're gonna look at it and think, yeah, this is super realistic.
Which you can see that come through on the game, as we said, because players now act more like a real life team, especially in defense. They're gonna have a more zonal marking sort of system. You're gonna notice that when a player comes through on goal, the defensive line drops back, kind of looking like it's real life football. That's exactly what we're seeing in the footballing world right now.
That's everything you need to know for FIFA 22.
If you have any questions, pop them down below at the FIFA Analyst and I'll give you a reply.
Don't forget to like, subscribe, and of course, hit that bell so you never miss an upload on the channel.